Hello students, today we are going to discuss about flow net. So this concept is there in the second unit, second chapter. So first, flow net. Flow net is a graphical representation of the path taken by water particles and the head variation along the path. So flow net is a concept which we can draw on the graph. So if we draw the path followed by the water particles and if we show the head variation along the path, so the graph is called as flow net. So here there are some definitions. So what is flow net? Path followed by a water particle is called as flow line. Path along which a water particle travels is called as flow line, and it is also called as stream line. Equipotential line, a line joining equal total heads. So equipotential line is a line which is connecting equal total heads. So flow path, flow path, as the name suggests, it is the space between two adjacent flow lines. Flow field, space between any two adjacent flow lines and equipotential lines is called as field. Now I'll show you an image where we can see these flow lines, equipotential lines, flow path and flow field. So here is the flow net diagram, students. So where we have drawn the flow lines below the dam. So whenever we are drawing the flow net, the imagination is the soil is saturated. See, so this is a graphical representation for the soil where it is existing below the dam. And obviously the soil will be saturated. So see, all these lines are imaginary lines or the lines which we are drawn, right? So the flow net diagram is a thing which we have drawn, right? So here is the dam. Okay, so we are drawing the diagrams are the lines, flow lines, equipotential lines for the water which is flowing below the dam. Okay, the flow is there through the soil. So our main intention is to analyze the flow through the soils, right? The main concept of the unit is flow through the soils, right? So we are doing the analysis for the flow which is there in the soil below the dams and which is saturated, right? So here is the flow line. The red lines are called as flow lines. Okay, so it is the flow line is the line which is connecting the path followed by a water particle, and we all know very well that the flow exists from the upstream to downstream. Okay, so this is the upper stream, this is the downstream. So you can see the head difference in the image, right? Delta H. So this is the upper level of water, this is the lower level of water, and delta H head is existing. So there is chance for the flow from the upstream to downstream. So there is one red line, second red line, third red line, and there is chance for fourth flow line also in the image, if you can see. So the red lines indicates flow lines. Okay, so what are the equipotential lines now? So these in the image, the blue lines, okay, all the blue lines are called as equipotential lines. So on his equipotential line, head is same, right? Equi means similar, potential means head. Similar head is existing on the equipotential line, right? So how many blue lines are there in the image? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 equipotential lines are there in the flow net diagram, which is shown, right? And we can calculate 8. We can add this also, 8.3. Not the complete equipotential line is present. The head we can consider it to be 8.3. So this is flow line and equipotential lines. So what is flow space? So space or the flow path is the space between two adjacent flow lines, right? Flow path is the space which is existing between two adjacent flow lines. So here you can see the image where the cross mark is present. So this area is flow field, okay? So the area is existing between two adjacent flow lines and also two adjacent equipotential lines. It is called as flow field, okay? So this is about flow net diagram and flow line, flow lines, equipotential lines, flow space, flow path and flow field. So now we'll see the assumptions of flow net. So whenever we are drawing the flow net diagrams, we need to assume these things. Soil is fully saturated, right? And Darcy's law is applicable. Soil is homogeneous and isotropic. Soil grains and water are incompressible. So you know the meaning of each one, right? So soil is fully saturated means where the degree of saturation is 100%, right? So Darcy's law is applicable for the laminar flow. When the flow is laminar, then Darcy's law is applicable. So you know the formula for Darcy's law, right? Where discharge is equal to K into I. Soil is homogeneous and isotropic. So soil is homogeneous means, homo means similar particles throughout the, similar properties throughout the soil in one direction, right? Isotropic means similar properties in all the directions at one point, right? So, and next assumption is soil grains and water are incompressible. So there won't be any change in the volume under the pressure. It is called as incompressible. So applications of flow net. So by using flow net diagrams, we can calculate uplift pressure and we can calculate exit gradient. We can calculate heaving and we can calculate pore water pressure. So by using flow net diagram, we can calculate uplift pressure. So it is a pressure which is existing against the gravity force. We can also calculate the exit gradient. So delta H by L, IE is equal to delta H by L, that we can calculate from the flow net diagram. So heaving is also a phenomena which is undergoing in the soil, right? So pore water pressure. So it is a pressure which is exerted by the water on the soil particles which is present in the pores. So I'll show you a problem. Okay. So how we can calculate this uplift pressure and the piping, exit radiant, heaving and pore water pressure. I'll show you a problem. By using the diagram, flow net diagram, we can calculate these four. So these are like piping and heaving, these are like failure phenomena in soils. So it is obvious that we need to calculate these things. So uplift pressure also, it is also like a failure phenomena in the soils. It creates problem in the soil. So it is obvious that we need to calculate these things. And we can calculate these things with the help of flow net. So that is why we are studying about the flow net concept. So properties of flow net. So the angle of intersection between each flow line and equipotential line must be 90 degrees, which means they should be orthogonal to each other. So if you see the flow net diagram, so flow line and equipotential line, right? So this is the flow line and this blue line is the equipotential line. So there is the angle of 90 degrees. They are orthogonal to each other or perpendicular to each other, we can say. And they are not meeting each other, right? Two flow lines are not meeting each other and also two equipotential lines are also not meeting at one point. So here it is said equal quantity of seepage occurs in each flow channel. So every channel is having the same seepage. So why it happens? Why the equal quantity of seepage occurs? Because the head is same. So the flow lines and equipotential lines meet at right angles each other. The flow line never cross each other. So as I said, they are divided. The two flow lines are divided. They never meet. Two equipotential lines also, they never meet. Flow and equipotential lines are smooth curves. It is not that flow line is a straight line. It is not that equipotential line is a straight line. Don't assume. So these are the curves which are drawn with the hand, right? The quantity of water flowing through each flow channel is the same. As I said, seepage is same. The same equipotential drop occurs between the successive equipotential lines. So as we said, equipotential line itself suggests the same head. Never start from the same point. Two flow lines and equipotential lines never start from the same point. Smaller the field, greater be a hydraulic gradient. So if you see the diagram, see the flow line is starting here, but the first equipotential line is starting here. They are not starting at the same point. Okay, if the seepage is low, there will be chances of existing more exit gradient. So there are methods to construct the flow net diagram: analytical method, electrical analogy method, capillary flow model, sand model and graphical method. So graphical method is the preferable method among all the things, easy method. Okay, so this is the flow net diagram. So these are the uses of flow net. Okay, so we can calculate the discharge, we can calculate total head, we can calculate pressure head, and we can calculate hydraulic gradient. So this is about the flow net diagram theory. So we discussed what is flow line, what is equipotential line, what is the flow path, what is the flow field, and what flow net diagram applications, and we have seen the methods by which we can draw the flow net diagrams and the uses, right, and the properties of flow net or the characteristics of flow net. So the question may be asked like this also, write down the characteristics of the flow net or the properties of flow net. Same answer.